team matchup. Well, always exciting when this guy shows up on the fight card, Daniel. He is a true mixed martial artist. Not really any glaring weaknesses, at least, that he's put on film thus far.
He's the new breed of fighter. Those kids that start doing everything at 6 years old. They start wrestling. They start doing jiu-jitsu. They start to box. He's one of those guys that has every one of those skills, and he does them all at an A-plus level. He's got tremendous cardio. He is the type of fighter that in a few years will just litter the UFC roster across the board.
And oftentimes his opponents will say he doesn't really do anything special, but he does everything at a plus level, and he believes he'll have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight. Well, DC, this is a true mixed martial artist of the highest order. You've watched the film. Hard for me to see much in terms of glaring weaknesses, and he believes he can react to anything that is thrown his way inside that octagon.
It's unbelievable, because whenever you're trying to prepare for someone, you look for weaknesses. But when you watch this guy, nothing jumps off the page. When you think I have to go wrestle him, you realize very quickly that not only can he defend takedowns, he can also go and secure them himself. He's that new breed of fighter that has been doing every discipline from the very start of his career. You know you're looking at a guy that will contend for a championship.
And if our fighter meeting on Thursday is any indication, confidence, not an issue for this young man coming in here tonight. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight fight. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age. Some differences in height and reach as well. And once again, here is the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 9 wins, no losses.
He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Stockholm, Sweden, Hamzat Borsjebagov. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 19 wins, 4 losses.
He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Gilbert Durinho Burns.
All right, commit to the rules of the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
They touch him up, and we are underway.
Ready?
Round one is upon us between two of the best fighters in this division. Hard to find anything resembling a glaring weakness on either side when you break down the
fight. There are no weaknesses in these guys. These guys are as well-rounded as they come. They both can wrestle, both can grapple, both can strike. They can do it all. And these are the matchups that we dream of as MMA fans.
And with authority, goes to the judo throw right into side control.
He's in side control. He's got a ton of options.
Trying to guard pass here, not today.
No, it ain't happening. Good job understanding the transition.
Get out of there. Trying to pass the guard here, but a nice job by the bottom fighter defensive.
Bottom fighter did a fantastic job of following with his hips, making sure he blocked any attempt to get past his guard.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Oh, man, this ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes.
Work the side control. Start giving them some elbows. Ground and pound.
All right, trying to pass here. As Glover Teixeira might say, not today.
Not today. Great job of following with the hips, keeping those legs locked and keeping them in full guard.
The ground and pound has been there all night.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Fighter trying to pass here, ooh, but gets denied.
Gets denied. Great job, great recognition of seeing what your opponent was trying to do.
Just over 2 minutes to go.
Keep the pressure going on that ground game.
Oh, trying to pass here, but Dikembe Mutombo style,
blocked.
He gets denied.
Blocked! Great job blocking that pass by the bottom fighter.
All right, north-south position now, DC. We'll see how he chooses to advance from here. Good, solid strike on the ground. 90 seconds and counting here in our opening round. Oh, nice combination of strikes here from the top, standing over his opponent, not unlike Muhammad Ali over Sonny Liston.
Oh, that is a good reference. If you're standing and your opponent's on the ground, you're doing really good work.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by Burns. Trying to guard pass here, not today.
No, it ain't happening. Good job understanding the transition.
All right, 45 seconds now to go in the round. All right, he's sort of hanging out here, unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, 20 seconds to go in the round. Solid strike on the ground. And he landed the right hand there. 10 seconds. Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter. He's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. All right, no Telestrator for DC tonight, but we'll get you some replays. And if you like face punching, that was a good round.
Yeah, where's my Telestrator, man? I want to draw this action. But yeah, John, you're right. It was the striking. It was the punches that really did allow him to take control of this round.
Listen, I need you to go out there, and I want you to do more of that. Let's set up those takedowns with your strike.
All right, here we go with our next round, and really shades of the Diaz brothers in that previous round. A lot of volume, a lot of accuracy, just a lot of efficiency on the field.
Very, very efficient. Good round in the sense that he did not throw everything with absolute power, but he was touching the entire time. Then every now and again, he would set down with a strike that was really damaging his opponent.
He
level change, leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Burns his passes denied. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Burns attempting to pass here, but he's denied by the defense. Well, you gotta stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here, nice punch. All right, he's got him in the north-south position now. I know the crowd thinks it's funny when this happens, but if you're the bottom fighter, nothing funny about it.
It's not funny. This is not a fun position to be in fighting. You've got to try and change it immediately because you are carrying someone's weight, whether it's their bottom half weight or the top half. You are carrying their weight, whether you got their armpit in your face or you got their legs over the top of you. It is not comfortable. So you need to be trying to move, make them make a decision, a determination as to what they're trying to accomplish, and then you try and counter it.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Burns is looking to pass here, denied by the opponent. Just over 2 minutes to go. Burns pass attempt denied. Under 2 minutes to go in round two. All right, north-south position here. We'll see if the crowd can be mature about this, DC.
I mean, he's walking the arm over. Oh, and he's attacking choke now.
Excuse me? Windshield choke.
Windshield choke. He took the arm with him. You usually see this in grappling competitions with the gi, John.
A lot of downward pressure here, DC. Gets the win by submission. Beautifully executed there on the ground. All right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He does a great job of staying patient. He doesn't rush or panic. You are never safe when you're fighting this guy. You're in a lot of trouble. You're in a lot of trouble the entire time when you're this good in the submissions.
So there he is, your winner by submission. That could hold up as one of the better subs of the year, near perfect execution tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 43 seconds of round number two. Playing the winner by tap out, Gilbert Durinho!
So what a performance by this young man here tonight as he gets the win by way of submission. He certainly put a lot of stock into getting the finish tonight, and he did just that. Congratulations.
It was a very tough fight, but he knew that if he did everything right, he can get to his position, which is the ground, and he would be able to find a finish by submission tonight. He did just that.